Again, I'm riding the aerial rider Kepler. This is one hill I will do. We're climbing to 15 mile an hour. Stop. 25.3 seconds is what it was actually time I stopped at the hill here. So yeah, that's a pretty good one here. Let's ride on up and see if I can find another hill there. So again, that was 25.3 with the, got one more here we're going to do. I'm going to go down this hill and we're going to come back up this one too. There's another good hill right here. And this one, we're going to stop right in front of this car here. And this is where we'll start this test. Pretty much even with the bumper, and this is a little better hill here. So let's see what it'll do going up this one. 3, 2, 1, go. Again, pedal assist 5. Throttle only. Still climbing, still gaining speed going up this steep hill, up to 17 mile an hour. We're gonna stop it right at the stop sign up here. Okay, that was 37 seconds. So again, we did 37 seconds on this one, and once I get done with this ride today, we will go back and get the juiced, and we'll compare it, see how it does. First hill climb test we did. I hope you guys can see my thing here, but yeah, I've got it in pedal assist 5. We're going to do throttle only. This is the first hill climb test, and then we'll be doing another one here as well. So 3, 2, 1, go. Again, pedal assist 5. Throttle only. We're at 10.6 mile an hour. And I can tell you right now, just from what I've experienced on the other bike, the Kepler outperformed this juiced rip current quite a bit. Okay, stop. 32 seconds was the first hill climb test. So now we'll go on down to the bottom of this hill and come back up it, and let's see what it'll do. But so far, it's not even close on the first test. The Kepler done much better going up the hill. So we will turn around here again and we'll start with the front bumper of this car like we did on the other one. And we'll do this one as well. So yeah, let me go ahead and reset my clock. And I think you guys can see that okay, but here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. This is a pretty steep incline. I'm thinking about an 8 to 10% grade. But as I'm climbing this hill, I'm losing speed. This battery is completely full, just as well as the Kepler was. And yeah, we're already to 33 seconds, and we're not even up to the top of the hill. The last one we stopped at the stop sign, so we'll be doing the same on the juiced rip current. Okay, it took 50 seconds to do that one. So I can tell you right there, just what I have done so far, it is not even close on the comparison between the Kepler and the juiced rip current. There's such a big difference in the hill climb test. So I'm a firm believer that with just all the 26-inch fat tire bikes I have reviewed, the Kepler by far has done a better hill climb test than any of them. Now again, if there are some other company and manufacturers out there watching this video, and you think your bike is faster or it does better hill climbing, I recommend you send me the bike and I will review it. But on my findings so far, the Kepler has outshined the Ranger and the juiced rip current. I mean, it's not even close. Now again, I have to correct it if I'm wrong, but I think this bike is still priced at $2,099. And the AeroRider Kepler is only $16.99 plus tax. So folks, I'm telling you right now, and I have done so many reviews on 26-inch fat tire bikes, from performance to range review, and I have not done a range review yet on the Kepler, so keep that in mind. But I can tell you right now, you better buy this bike. For the price of $16.99, I don't think there's a better bike out there. That's going to beat this Kepler. Now, I suggest you go down to my link and order it off my YouTube channel. I got a link down in the description box. You may save a little money on the Kepler, but it really helps out the bike channel as well if you guys click on the links on my YouTube channel. So yeah, let me know what you guys think of these hill climb tests that we've done. Again, I'm gonna have my grandson put these two bikes, the Rip Current S, the juiced Rip Current S, and the Kepler from AeroRider. We're going to put these on a split screen so you guys can compare these two tests. I mean, I am just thoroughly amazed how well the Kepler has handled on a downtown ride, a city neighborhood ride, climbing up hills. I also am releasing a video, I think I already did today, on how well the Kepler did on the city ride yesterday that we took. Now don't get me wrong, all three of these bikes are good quality bikes. But for $400 less and $1,000 less, it's a no-brainer for me which bike I'm going to choose. So let me know what you guys think. Put any comments down in the comment box. I answer everything that comes in if I can. So anyway, we're going to stop the video right here. I want to thank you guys for watching the video and sharing, like, and subscribe. Hit that bell notification. And I will see you guys on the next video.